During that episode, you see, when he knows that Rama is in search of Sita, he remembers some time back some of my monkey followers had found a little cloth bundled with set of ornaments. And maybe it belongs to Sita, who knows? Then he says, wait, I have got something, let me show it to you. So he sends and gets the bundle and puts it before Rama. Do you think this might have belonged to your wife whom Ravana has abducted and taken away? So the bundle is opened. There are many ornaments. The very thought of Sita, the very mention of her name, makes him once again overcome with grief. And his eyes are dimmed with the tears of grief. And so he is not able to properly see the ornaments. And so he takes it one by one and shows it to Lakshmana. Oh Lakshmana, oh my brother, see whether this is your Bhabhi's ornaments. Is it my beloved Sita's ornaments? See this, one by one, necklace, earring, nose, ornament. And as Rama takes one after another and shows it to Lakshmana, Lakshmana shakes his head. He said, no, I don't recognize it. Until at last the toe rings of Sita are picked up by Rama from the cloth and showed, put before Lakshmana. See, are you able to? Lakshmana says, yes. This I am able to recognize. Other things I have not been able to recognize at all. Naham janami keyore, naham janami kundale, nupure tu abhijanami nityam padabhi vandanat. He says, all this, keyore is here, kundala is here. These things I do not recognize because I have never seen them. I never raised my head and looked at Mother Sita. So I don't recognize any of the ornaments she wore. But I recognize the toe rings because every day I used to go and prostrate at her feet. And when I used to offer my prostrations at her feet every morning, I used to see it every day. These are hers. I recognize. This is Lakshmana. See? This is the greatness of Lakshmana, the concealed greatness of this great being. And no wonder, he was the constant companion of Mahavishnu in Vaikuntha Kshirasagara because he was the avatar of Mahashesha. See? Lakshmana was the avatar of Mahashesha. Just as Balarama was the avatar of Mahashesha in Krishna avatara, Lakshmana was the avatar of Mahashesha. So this Lakshmana, who had never raised his head and gazed at Sita, naturally when he was following her, as Rama was leading the way and Sita was coming behind him and Lakshmana was taking up the rear, he always walked with his head fixed to the ground, gaze fixed to the ground. But so great was intense love for his elder brother. From time to time he used to be overcome with longing to have a glimpse of his brother. He wanted to have a look at Lord Rama. This desire used to fill his heart. He used to be overcome with this great longing to see Rama, but he cannot see her. See him, because Sita ji is there. And it is said in Ramayana that she being the all-knowing divine mother, see, Mahalakshmi herself, the cosmic power, the moment this longing came into the heart of Lakshmana, she immediately divined it. Immediately she knew it. And so, out of her great compassion and love, the moment she felt this brother is wanting to seize, it appears she used to step aside, leave the footpath and step aside. On some pretext, step aside. So there was nothing in between Lakshmana and Rama. And the moment she stepped aside, she heard the banglet sound going away from before him, then he'll be filled with joy. He raises his head, gaze at Rama's broad back and Ajana Bhav, and be filled with joy.